Together,
European Empire
and the Ottoman Empire, the Turkish.
Turkish Empire, yes. Ottoman Empire.
Ottoman Empire. The Ottoman Empire has been tolerant, very tolerant to its subjects, whereas the Europeans have failed dismally. I was wondering if Huzoor may be able to explain.
पुलिस तो कहने की अंग्रेजी में नहीं समझ आ रही है, कहते हैं कि
एक ऑटोमन एम्पायर जो टर्क्स थे.
Who says that?
He said that.
They were not tolerant at all. They are not tolerant even now.
Yes, this was a question, Huzoor. That was
it. Is a false impression of yours that they were tolerant. They never tolerated. They never tolerated the differences between the view of the government and the view of the individuals. And they took very severe action against the individual views. So the very question is based on a wrong assumption. Right?
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
The
next question is Dr. Shabbir Ahmed Sahib, South East London.
Rao sir, you are a good doctor, but you can't do anything about the headache of your wife. I have just received a letter from her and she has disclosed this.
He said nobody can.
But that is your headache. I say that is your headache, you have to do something.
It is true, yes.
Yes?
But I like the headache.
You like the one who is suffering from headache?
Yes. In the Holy Quran, we are enjoined to send salutations upon Hazrat Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the verse A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alaihi wasallimu taslima. Yet when we send our salutations, we also include alayhi as advised by our holy master sallallahu alaihi wasallam, though not mentioned in the Holy Quran. Why is this?
What is not mentioned in the Holy Quran?
The alayhi. Sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima.
Yes, but don't you say that in your prayers daily?
I do, but it's not in the Holy Quran.
The Holy Prophet understood the Quran better than you, didn't he?
Of course, this is why I was hoping.
He quoted his al.
Right. I was thinking it was perhaps a reflection of his rahmatul alameen that he included his al, even though it was not specific.
You can go on expanding the point to envelop the entire world, that's possible. But the fact is that in the prayer, whatever Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught you has to be based on the Holy Quran. He never said anything from his own heart. It was always based in some verses of the Quran. Whether you understand or not on which verse he based this, but this is definitely certain that in the prayer of in At-Tahiyyat, during At-Tahiyyat, you say Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin. Don't you say that?
We do.
Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin.
Yes. May I ask a second question?
Yes, please.
It is recognized that during sajda or prostration, the verses of the Holy Quran should not be recited.
Correct.
However, there are some verses in the Holy Quran which are quotations of other people, like La ilaha illa anta subhanaka. In despair, if somebody...
Whatever is even quoted in the Holy Quran should not be recited during sajda.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah.
Azur, dissection of dead human bodies is an important part of the training of medical students.
Correct.
When inshallah in near future Ahmadiyyat becomes the predominant system of the world, where are we going to obtain the dead bodies from?
From the dead bodies?
Who will allow their loved ones to be dissected?
They themselves will that after our death our body may be dissected. There will be many who will do that. There won't be shortage of dead bodies then.
Next question is Bashir Adarabio from
Bashir what?
Adarabio.
Adarabio.
He
is from
London Mosque address. He is
originally
Nigeria.
Nigeria.
Assalamu alaikum warahmatullah.
Wa alaikum assalam warahmatullah.
Hazur, I'm sure like millions of Ahmadis all over the world have been enjoying your recent sermons about Al-Rahim attributes of God. In my observation, man, especially people in authorities, have learned little or nothing about this excellent attribute of God. I also know that man can never be like God. Man can never be as generous as God. But what can we do at least to go a little bit close to this excellent attribute of God?
You seem to listen to my sermons carefully. What you are expected to do is that you try to transform your personality in accordance with these sermons with relation to the attributes of Allah, particularly nowadays I'm talking about Rahimiyat. So if you learn how to be Rahim in the light of these sermons, then you cannot be God, but you can follow God and you can acquire a habit of submitting to the will of God in accordance with His attributes. Right?
Yes, if I may say, this is an Islamic teaching. Everybody knows that laws are strictest in the Islamic world. Everybody knows that the laws, the Sharia laws that are used in Islamic countries like Saudi Arabia and the rest of them are very strict, that you do something, the chop off your hand, your arm, or things like that. It doesn't seem they following this.
But who is responsible for that?
Sorry, sir?
Who is responsible for that?
Man.
Not I.
Not you, no. Man, of course, people in authority.
They misinterpret the Quran and the Sunnah, and in accordance with their misinterpretation, they act wrongly. That's all what can be said in answer to your question.
JazakAllah, sir.
Next question is Sayyid Nasir Ahmed Shah Sahib.
Sayyid Nasir Ahmed Sahib. Yes.
Sorry, Kazim. As in Quran Surah Nu, ayat number 17, Bismillah Shaitan Rajim, وجعل القمر فيهن نورا وجعل الشمس سراجا. Here, Qamar or the moon has been named as Nur, and the Shams or the sun has named as Siraj. Whereas Allah Subhanahu wa Taala has also said in the Quran, it says, "Allah Nur as-samawati wal-ard." So I don't want to understand why Nur
is
different.
See, similar question was asked before about the meaning of different words with reference to different text contexts. Allah Nur as-samawati wal-ard initially means, initially it has so many meanings, that all that is considered light comes from Allah. The sun itself would be dark if there was no light reflected by the sun from Allah. So Allah is Nur as-samawati wal-ard in that sense. Where it is said Siraja Munira and moon to be the Nur, their Siraj is sun, and the reflected light of the sun from the moon is called Nur. because Noor has